Greetings, and welcome to dbForge Studio for MySQL tutorials. You know that Studio, an advanced IDE for MySQL database development, management, and administration, is a classic Windows application. But in this video, you will learn how to install and run it on a Mac without compromising your experience. For that purpose, you can use CrossOver, a commercial compatibility solution that allows running Windows apps on macOS and Linux and offers a free trial to get acquainted with its capabilities. Let's see how it works. CrossOver is an application that you install on your Mac. In this application, you can create customizable Windows environments and store them in separate containers called bottles. When you start installing a new Windows application, like dbForge Studio, CrossOver creates a new bottle automatically. You can have as many bottles as you need. Moreover, you can store multiple Windows applications in a single bottle if these applications require the same configurations. You could say that CrossOver works similarly to virtualization solutions such as Parallels Desktop. In a way, yes, but there's a difference. If you choose Parallels Desktop, you need to purchase and deploy it first. And while you are setting it up, you need to purchase a new Windows license, then install and configure it on your Parallels Desktop. And only then can you install and run Windows applications on it. When it comes to CrossOver, everything is much simpler. No Windows license needed. First, you install CrossOver Mac on your machine. Then you run it and install the apps of your choice along with the required prerequisites. CrossOver will notify you if something is missing. And that's it. Now that you know how CrossOver works, let's proceed to install it. First, go to the official CodeWeavers website and download its archive. Then double-click the downloaded archive to extract the application, click Open to launch it, and then agree to move it to your Applications folder. Once it's done, you can proceed with installing the main prerequisite component required for the Studio to run properly, .NET Framework 4.7.2. To do that, open CrossOver. On the Install a Windows Application page, start typing Microsoft.NET Framework 4.7.2 in the search box. Next, click it in the results. Then on its dedicated page, click Install. You will be prompted to select a bottle for the .NET Framework package to be installed into. Click Select a bottle to either create a new bottle or select an existing one. If you create a new bottle, specify the bottle name and make sure that you select a Windows 10 64-bit bottle type. Then click Done. The installation of the .NET Framework package begins. Please note that it may take some time. Now the installer will guide you through all the steps. You will need to agree to the license terms and confirm the reboot of the bottle environment by clicking Restart Now after each prerequisite is installed. Note that your machine will not be rebooted. After the successful installation of the last required component, .NET Framework 4.7.2, click Finish. Now CrossOver is ready to install dbForge Studio into the bottle. Before you begin, download the dbForge Studio installer file from our official website and place it in a folder of your choice. Then, in CrossOver, go to the newly created bottle and click either Install in the lower left corner of the screen or Install Application into Bottle under Bottle Actions. On the Install a Windows Application page, click Install an unlisted application. On the Unlisted Application page, click Install. Now you need to specify the location of the previously downloaded installer file. In our case, it's the default Downloads folder. Find and select the required file and click Choose Installer. The installation begins and CrossOver proceeds to install dbForge Studio. In the installer window that opens, click Install. On the Select Destination page, select the folder for the Studio to be installed into and click Next. On the File Associations page, you can keep all the selected settings unchanged. Click Next. On the Startup Optimization page, select the preferred option and click Next. Please note that if you select to generate images, the installation will require extra time, but the application launch will commence faster in the future. After the installation is completed, click Finish. Note that the Launch dbForge Studio for MySQL checkbox should be cleared in order to let CrossOver properly finalize the installation. CrossOver will confirm a successful installation, and dbForge Studio for MySQL will appear in the bottle. Now you can launch it and freely explore its capabilities on your machine. Last but not least, before you launch Studio, we suggest you turn on the High Resolution Mode toggle in the bottle configuration under Advanced Settings. Then reboot the bottle by clicking Reboot Bottle and enable High Resolution Mode. This will make your work with the Studio more convenient. There is one more thing that we find worth mentioning. If you're an avid user of Terminal, you can use it to run dbForge Studio. As an example, let's back up the Sequila database. This is the command that initiates CrossOver. This is the parameter that specifies the name of the bottle that contains dbForge Studio for MySQL. These are the options that configure the launch of the application. Finally, this is the command that runs our backup with the specified options. Let's run it. The backup process begins, and it finishes successfully. That's it. We have backed up our database. Note that you can easily run batch files and automate the launch of dbForge Studio from the command line using the standard scheduler. Ready to try it for yourself? Then don't hesitate to get a free trial of dbForge Studio for MySQL. Just download it from our official website and check it in action.